In today's tutorial, I'm going to show you how to vectorize your own hand lettering. First, you'll want to draw out your piece using dark black ink and white image.
So, I'm going to open Preview on my Mac, and then I'm going to go to File, Import from my scanner. I'm going to change this to color. I'm going to leave it at 400. You should maybe do it at least at 300. I'm going to select the area that I want to scan, and then I'm going to hit scan. I like to do it at high resolution just so I can get the cleanest image so that when I bring it into Photoshop and then later into Illustrator, it's just going to turn into a vector much cleaner. Okay, so now I'm going to save as the song Maps. You can see I added a couple more days because I didn't really like this day. So it doesn't really matter how the layout is, because we can always adjust that.
Now that that's done and we have it all scanned in, I'm just going to drag that saved file into Photoshop so I can open that up there, clean it up, and get it ready for importing to Illustrator.
So I'm just going to go to Image and rotate 90 degrees clockwise so we can read it, and just zoom in a little bit so we can see it. What I normally do, this is my process anytime I'm vectorizing any of my lettering, it's the quickest and easiest way. I go into Levels, I grab the black eyedropper, click on the black, and I go to the white, click on the white, and now I have a pretty good contrast of white and black. Sometimes that's enough, sometimes it's not. If it's not enough, play around with the brightness and the contrast to see what you get. If you have too much contrast, you're going to get a bit of jagged edges there, so you don't want to have really jagged edges, because then when we bring into Illustrator, you're going to see that. So you can play around that. You can also play around with curves if you want to bring up the white, the black. So usually, though, what I did first is enough. So then I'm going to save for web and save this as a JPEG. And then I'm going to grab that new image, drag it into Illustrator. So you're going to make sure the image is selected, and you should have image trace on your toolbar. There's usually presets in here. I have one that I have already saved that I like to use, which is this one. And basically, I'll show you what it looks like, and then I'll undo and do it step by step. It gets rid of the background, and even in this one, the threshold was too high and it got rid of too much. So I'm just going to do this from scratch. So I'm going to click Image Trace. Then I'm going to click the Image Trace panel to bring up more settings. And I'm just going to go through here and see what looks best. So I'm going to move the threshold up and down to see what works. So I'm liking it a little bit better now. There's still some wonky areas, but we'll be able to fix that with the editing afterwards. The least amount of paths, the better, because then you have less paths to work with, but you still need a lot of paths to get the curves. But if you have too many path points, it's going to get messy, and you like to have clean round edges, and if you have too many paths, it can be more like jagged and not nice and rounded, if that makes sense. So again, just move these sliders and see what looks good. this, you can see what it does and what it doesn't do, so you want to keep fill checked. However, you may not want strokes. And I usually click on ignore white. So it's totally different for every design. You just kind of have to move things around. Once you're happy with it, you're going to hit expand. And then you're going to ungroup it. And then you're going to delete this outside part. And we're going to grab, I'm going to just create a new document letter size. And I'm just going to grab this. And I'm going to copy it and paste. And then I'm just grabbing it and holding shift to size down and keep my proportions. So this is now an SVG for a vector, sorry. So this means that you can resize it to whatever size you want because it's no longer a pixel. I'm also gonna grab the they that I did here that I liked better, which I think is this one. And I'm just gonna drag this down for now. So, start with weight. So you're going to use mainly this arrow, and this arrow. There are quicker ways to do this if you have a tablet and a Wacom tablet with a stylus. You can draw on it to erase some of the lines or draw more lines on top. Or you can just use your mouse or your trackpad, which is the example I'm showing you now. And this is what I do. I find it the quickest, easiest way. There's so many videos out there for different ways to do this. So, you know, try a bunch of different approaches and see what works for you. So to select the whole word, use the black arrow, which is the selection tool. And to select paths, you use the white arrow, which is the direct selection tool. And to remove points, you're going to use delete anchor point. Now you're really going to want to use the shortcuts for these. It just makes this process a lot quicker, and it is a long, tedious process. So anything you can do to help that is definitely beneficial. So you're going to want to know that delete anchor point tool is the minus sign. Direct selection tool is A, and selection tool is V. And if you are using one of the direct selection tools and you want to use a different tool, like if you select delete anchor point and then you hold command, it's going to flip back to the tool you were just on. So I was just on this direct selection tool but went back to this delete anchor point tool. And if I hit command, you'll see how my cursor changes from the pen tool to the arrow, which makes it really fast. So when I'm going through here, what I do is I keep it on the minus delete anchor point tool, and then I use command to flip back between these two so that I can easily select. So for right here, I'm going to delete this one. And then I'm going to grab this handle by holding command, which brings me the arrow tool back, and then just dragging this to the position that I want. I'm going to do the same here. I'm going to delete, grab the command key, which brings up the direct selection tool, and adjust that. So I just continue to do this throughout the whole process, which is long, I know. But once you get the hang of it, it goes by pretty quickly, and sometimes it's actually kind of calming to do. So you're just going to want to do this for whole word for the whole sentence, actually. And and make sure that it looks the way you want it to look, nice and clean, because as you can see when you scan these in, it doesn't look exactly like the sketch that you did with the marker. It has some weird lines and some jagged edges, which is normal, and we're going to try to fix that with this path tool adjustment. So you can check out my process right now. I'm going to speed it up so you can see it being done in like a tenth of the time, just so you can see what I do from beginning to end.
Once you've got that all cleaned up, it's ready to use for any project. It's completely scalable to any size. I'm using it over an image just to give you an idea of what you can do. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe for more.